endless growth, are they compatible? Well, I'm an environmental scientist, so you can probably guess what I'm going to say. But if we look at a healthy planet, okay, what is the health scorecard for custodianship of our wonderful gem of a planet, given what we've been doing for the last couple of centuries? Denial of ecological reality, and sadly our schools and universities by and large don't teach people about that reality. We've also failed to come to grips with population, which is a taboo word. We've failed to come to grips with consumerism and overconsumption. Shop till you drop is often praised as a wonderful thing you can go out and do. And of course the failure to improve social inequity and inequality of income, which is rapidly worsening in most societies.
Cultivating a sense of satisfaction, being satisfied with what we have and not aspiring to accumulate for the sake of accumulation. So these are the paradigms that are already embedded within Hinduism, and which I, as a member of the Australian Council of Hindu Clergy, we are being very active in getting our priests to actually talk about these environmental issues when they're conducting ceremonies.
Healthy earth, endless growth, are they compatible? And the answer is clearly no. And yet the downward spiral continues, and there are very few, I'm sorry to say, glimmers of hope.
Our Jewish scriptures teach that God is the creator and the owner of the earth, and that people are simply the custodians, and that it is incumbent on us to protect the earth and to ensure that all the children of God and God's creation can enjoy the fruits.
Importance of breaking away from the mindset of endless growth. The need to break with the past and the present mindset. The need to break the chains they create, and so to break through to a new way of viewing structures.
One thing that Islam talks about is that it says that human beings have a nafs. And this is our desires, it's our negative emotional instincts, things such as greed, anger, selfishness. This is why we are so attracted to consumerism or by multinational corporations, even though they know they're destroying people's lives, they're attracted to growth.